Hey guys, Subaru Mike here, and in today's video, we take a look at Cursed Video Game, Andy's Apple Farm. Recently, I played through Andy's Apple Farm, and we got our first taste of its cryptic story. In this follow-up video, we'll look at every secret found within the game, as of version 1.4 that is, and then finish up the video by explaining the mysterious story as revealed by said secrets and Easter eggs. So sit back, relax, and let's investigate the haunted world of Andy's Apple Farm. Before even booting into the game, there are a couple of creepy Easter eggs to uncover. When brightening the game's options menu, we see the spooky possessed version of Andy staring back at us from the darkness. Next, when loading up a new game, we are also presented with the option to resume a previous save file, though this one wasn't left by the player. Rather, it seems to be from the previous person who experienced the game. All 8 stickers have been collected. When clicking on this second file, nothing seems to happen, but keep trying and eventually the game will crash and we are presented with the following error message. Brighten the screen here and we see a haunting image of fictional game developer Thomas Eastwood, the man behind the creation of this educational video game, Andy's Apple Farm.
Hello, this is Eastwood, Thomas Eastwood. If you're hearing this, welcome to the beta test of Andy's Apple Farm. As a beta tester, your goal is to find bugs and glitches and report them to me. I am fully aware the game is not finished, however, I will update the game as time goes on. Thank you, beta tester.
When first starting up the game, Andy meets his friends Klaus, Felix, Margaret, and Melody, who explain they have taken the key to his house. In order to get it back, Andy, and by extension the player, must complete 4 simplistic minigames, 1 per character. Klaus's minigame is only accessible after the other 3 have been beaten, and so we must choose from Felix, Margaret, or Melody. Each contain their own dark secrets, but also give out a secret message. The catch is that we can only see 1 secret message per playthrough, as each message is tied to the first minigame played. So let's go through each in turn. If Felix's minigame is the first we choose to play, then returning to the picnic bench area presents us with the following message. He drowned that day, at the bottom of the lake. She didn't save him. It's not her fault. It's not her fault. If Margaret's minigame is the first played, then the picnic area message will read as follows. The time was supposed to be happy, but she could feel her skin peeling off. And finally, if we choose to play with Melody first, then returning to the picnic area grants us access to this creepy message. She's not gone. She's still here. She wants you to free us. Please free us. Please free us. After receiving these messages, the game will crash and lead us into a screen explaining an irregularity has occurred, and prompting us to restart the game. This will always pop up after the first minigame has been completed, but if we stick around for long enough, a lengthy piece of background audio will play out, beginning with what sounds like someone driving. Next, we can make out the sound of footsteps on snow or perhaps frozen dirt. This leads into the sound of someone listening in to a muffled conversation inside a house. This leads into the sound of someone typing on a computer and executing a command line. After this, we hear what sounds like liquid of some kind being sloshed around a room. This ends with the audio of a lighter being lit, suggesting the liquid may be gasoline. Then we hear footsteps once more, but this time they are much faster, running on snowy earth. The final noise seems to be from the early stages of a fire, the flames beginning to form and crackle against a wooden structure. This background audio makes little sense now, but will make perfect sense by the time we finish uncovering Andy's secrets at the end of this video. So next, let's move on to each of the four mini-games. Felix sits by the lakeside fishing, and his mini-game requires us to catch three fish while making sure to avoid snagging any boots. One secret we can instantly unlock when interacting with Felix is found by simply turning down his offer to play a game.
I don't think you heard me right.
It's pretty creepy seeing a pair of super realistic human eyes appear on this cartoon character, though this has more meaning than you may think. More on this later. The next secrets occur after we catch three fish and a body appears at the bottom of a lake. This body is hookable, and depending on what we do with it, one of two Easter eggs will play out. When returning the body to Felix, we unlock this scene.
Search is underway for a child who fell off a rowboat and never resurfaced Thursday evening. According to the Pumpkin County Sheriff's Office, deputies responded to the scene yesterday, October 14. The victim, a 10-year-old male, and his sister fell off a rowboat late at night. The girl returned home safely, however, the young boy has not been found as of yet.
While dragging the body along the riverbed to the far right of the screen unlocks this chilling sequence. But it wasn't her fault. Next up, we have Margaret's fruit sorting minigame, where the objective is to pick up apples, cherries and pears and place them into the correct baskets. However, for the first secret, we are going to ignore this objective completely and instead move the cursor off screen top right. The following jump scare and sequence plays. We see the words, "You know exactly what you did," the image of a woman with her eyes blacked out, and this leads to a family photo taken on Christmas Eve of 1981. The message beneath reads, "But that would be the last Christmas they spent together." The music then distorts, as does the picture and date. By Christmas 1982, the family members were all dead. The second secret can be discovered after successful completion of Margaret's minigame. While Margaret thanks us, we must hit spacebar multiple times, with this leading to the following scene.
Thank you so much for helping me out, Andy. For all your help, I'll lay my eyes on you.
You're acting like nothing even happened. Do you even care what happened? You've got to be kidding me. It wasn't her fault. It was an accident that was out of our control. Out of our control, yes, but hers? She was right there. Why didn't she save him? She was scared, Thomas. You cannot blame her for that. Why not? Shut up, just shut the hell up. I'm not going to let you blame her over an accident. Get out. Just leave, Thomas. Just go to the bar and drink or something. You're good at that. This woman then changes into the avatar of Margaret, and the game returns to normal. Moving over to Melody's minigame next, and once again, there are several secrets to unlock. These are fairly easy to access. Simply be sure to complete this music-themed game second or third to unlock this secret sequence. Andy appears in a snowy area outside a house in the woods. Approaching the house reveals it is Christmas and allows Andy to eavesdrop on a conversation between mother and daughter inside. Isabella, what's wrong? It's just not the same. It's not the same without them. Hey, it's not your fault. No, I know it's my fault. Everything is my fault. No, it's not, Bella. You were so... I'm the reason Dad left. I'm the reason Louis is gone. I just want our family back together, but things are out of my control. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. After this conversation ends, Andy enters the house only to discover it has burnt to the ground. After a few moments, a disturbing series of sounds and images flash up on screen. However, if when spawning into this area we take the lower path to the right of the screen, instead of reaching the house, Andy reaches a car. Entering the car plays a recording dated April 13th, 1982.
Hey, is this thing on? Cool. Hey Kim, you wanna see this? She seems busy. Anyways, I've been experimenting with a lot of cool technology recently. A lot of the video games I've been putting together haven't really been accepted by a lot of the publishers, so I was like, I need to do something really cool with this next one. So here's the first version of the new game I'm working on. I'm calling it Apple Acres for now, but I'm still working on the title. This game features all sorts of new technology that I've been working on. It has something called a cinema screen type monitor, so I feel like it'd be more immersive like movies. And on top of that, I've even allocated a lot of memory to adding fully cartoon characters during cutscenes. There's no way this one can't do well. Can't afford to have another flop. I've also been thinking about some other types of technology to make the characters a bit more lifelike. I don't know. It's not very...
Last up, we come to Klaus for the fourth and final minigame of Andy's Apple Farm version 1.4. Klaus challenges Andy to a game of I Spy, and once again, two secrets can be discovered here. The first secret is another Out of Bounds Easter egg, and this can be unlocked by moving the cursor off screen towards the bottom right of the frame. We see the words, "I'm sorry, please stop." A conversation in a bar at Christmas time then plays out between Thomas and his friend Arthur. Hey Arthur. Yeah man, what's up? Have you been checking up on them like you said? Of course. Well, how are they doing? They're doing great, they're just getting ready for Christmas. I miss Christmas, it was always his favourite. Well anyway, you haven't been hanging too close to Cameron, right? Of course not. Why would you think that? You know me, I worry too much. I wouldn't want to be best friends with a liar, right? You're not a liar, right? You're not a liar, right? The second and even more disturbing scene plays when we complete the Klaus minigame successfully and then click on Klaus's avatar thereafter.
Yes, that's it. I spy with my little eye something.
Jeez.
Klaus explores the burned remains of the Eastwood family home, and is then chased down by an axe-wielding version of Andy. The scene eventually switching to a confrontation between Thomas and Arthur in the cornfields. Where are they, Arthur? I don't know, put down the axe. What are you doing? I'm sick and tired of you lying to me. Wait, Thomas, stop. You killed them. Oh God, what have I done? Earlier, we heard of a sister who lost her brother at the lake after they both fell out of a rowboat. The missing boy was never found, presumed dead after drowning in the lake that day. We see this elaborated on in the next secret. To access it, head to the bottom left of the central hub area and over to this tree line. A secret's path can be located, taking the player out of bounds and onto a black screen. Various characters appear here. We see Melody and Felix bidding Andy farewell, and next pass by a group of fish. Then we pass a horrifically glitched version of both Melody and Felix, and a scrambled version of Andy before reaching a secret screen. The secret scene shows a young girl crying by the rowboat at the lakeside. When interacting with her, she speaks the following lines. "I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. It's all my fault. What are Mum and Dad going to say? I'm sorry, Louis. I'm sorry I couldn't. I'm sorry." We then see images flash up on screen of water and a photograph of Louis. Garbled dialogue plays quickly in the background. When slowed down and reversed, this is what the audio translates to. After Andy collects all stickers, the following cutscene plays.
"You got all the bonus stickers. You did it, so now it's time for your prize.
So where are my keys? Oh, they're just in there. In there?
Yep, just go right through that door.
It's kinda dark, isn't it?
Just go right ahead, don't be scared. Yeah, just go get your keys.
Well, if you guys say so. Hey guys, I can't see anything in here. How am I supposed to find my keys? Guys? Hey, wait, no, let me out of here. Oh boy, I'm gonna have to find the light. It sure is dark in here."
Once inside the barn, we must click on two staircases, and after doing so, various exits around the barn unlock. Only one is accessible per run, and depending on which we leave through, the following secrets can be uncovered. Heading through the bottom right exit reveals a picture of Arthur King, with a date of death December 24th, 1982. We then see a brief shot of the Klaus character. Head through the lower right exit and a picture of Cameron Eastwood appears, her date of death also being December 24th, 1982. We then see a Christmas tree. Head through the middle right exit and we are greeted with a picture of Thomas Eastwood. His date of death is the 17th of March 1983. If we head through the upper left doorway, then this creepy sequence featuring Louis Eastwood plays out. You may notice Louis only has a missing date and not a death date, so we must ask the question, did he really drown in the lake that day after all? The final door secret can be found when leaving through the lower left exit. Upon doing so, a brief image fades into view. It seems to be an advert for an old game system and reads as follows. "The future is here. Introducing the Eastwood Games Cinema Screen Monitor Portable Computer. This portable computer has a wider screen than the standard monitor. It also has a lot of power and can run all sorts of fun games. The Cinema Screen Portable Computer comes with a computer, a keyboard, as well as a brand new game, Andy's Apple Farm, bundled with the package to display the device's powerful hardware and display performance." The last secret in this area is a string of binary code, which flashes up for a brief second when we run into these eyes chasing us around the barn. I haven't managed to translate this code as it seems to get cut off. Luckily, we are given more than enough information elsewhere to explain the story so far. But with that said, there are a few more secrets left to uncover first, so let's continue our search. After escaping the barn, Andy comes face to face with a new character called Peter the Pumpkin.
Wait, who are you?
I'm Peter the Pumpkin. Nice to meet ya.
Wait, how long have you been in here?
That doesn't matter. You wanna play a game of tag?
No, I'm just looking for my keys.
Sounds great. Let's play. Just this way, to the haystack maze.
Wait, who even are you?
After this movie wraps up, we are transported into a maze where our task is to tag Peter Pumpkin. If we successfully catch up to him, then the screen freezes and the following text can be seen. I just wanted to see my family again. I knew what I was doing was risky. I didn't want it to turn out this way. Free us. Save us. Help us. However, if we let Peter collect up all the pumpkins before we manage to catch him, or we simply exit the maze without even trying, then a very creepy sequence begins. Check it out. I can see it. It's been following me. I think it's watching me. But it doesn't have eyes. The final area of the game takes place in near total darkness, as this time it is Andy who must escape Peter Pumpkin. There isn't a great difference between the outcome of this minigame. There is simply some Caesar cipher which appears if we manage to evade capture. Here are both outcomes of the minigame, as well as the current ending to Andy's Apple Farm version 1.4. Stick around after for a quick story explained rundown, compiling all evidence collected up throughout this video. I should have known what I got myself into. It's my fault. It's my fault. You, on the other side, can help me. Save me. Save us. It is important to note that Andy's Apple Farm is still in development, and frequent updates will continue the story beyond this video. For now though, here is a rundown of events using the secrets we collected throughout the video. The Eastwoods were a family of four who lived in a secluded farmhouse in the early 1980s. The father was Thomas Eastwood, mother Cameron, daughter Isabella, and son Lewis. Thomas also had a best friend named Arthur King, who he would meet up with at the local bar. Thomas was a games developer who was in desperate need of a success after his last few titles had failed to be picked up by publishers. Thomas began development on a new game called Apple Acres, which would eventually become Andy's Apple Farm. Not only did Thomas develop this new game project, it seems he invested in the creation of an entire computer system too, the Cinema Screen Monitor Portable Computer. Thomas hoped this game and system would revolutionise the medium with all sorts of new technology never before witnessed on the video game scene at that time. But Thomas hints at taking things one step further, mentioning he considers using other types of technology to make the characters more lifelike. What exactly he meant by this remains a mystery at this time, but it does suggest something perhaps a little more paranormal in nature. It seems development of this game and computer began in 1981. However, the following year, on October 14th, 1982, Thomas's son Lewis drowned in the lake while on a boat ride with his sister Isabella. She was unable to save him after the two fell out of a rowboat, seemingly stopped by a shadowy entity who held her back, forcing Isabella to watch as her baby brother disappeared into the murky depths of the lake. But Lewis's body was never found, ruling out his death as a certainty. Isabella fell into despair, blaming herself for the accident. Thomas also blamed his daughter and turned to alcohol as a coping mechanism. Eventually, his abusive behavior and drinking led to his eviction from the family, his wife Cameron throwing him out soon after. It seems Thomas's behavior was a result of the dark entity influencing him. It transitioned from Isabella over to Thomas and began to whisper to him by night, feeding off his misery and infiltrating his mind. Arthur was tasked with watching over the Eastwood family by Thomas, and this led to an implied love affair between himself and Cameron. We see a stocking with an A stitched upon it in the Eastwood house in this scene here. Cameron was distraught after losing her son and husband, and so turned to Arthur for companionship. Influenced by the malicious spirit and raging jealousy, Thomas found out about Arthur's affair with his ex-wife and called him out on it on Christmas Eve 1982. In a blind, drunken rage under the influence of an evil spirit, Thomas drove from the bar that night to his family home. This is where those mysterious game over noises come into play. Thomas copied the Andy's Apple Farm files from the family computer, then poured gasoline everywhere and set a fire, burning his family alive in the process. A short while later, Arthur arrived at the scene of the crime to check in on Cameron and Isabella, but found only the ashes of the Eastwood house and a very angry Thomas, who took an axe and chased Arthur into the nearby fields where he slaughtered him in cold blood. After doing so, the spirit controlling Thomas left his body, allowing him to realize the crime he had just committed. This is confirmed not only by the ending sequence, but also a hidden cutscene which appears on a YouTube account linked to an ARG for the game. This account was set up by a person claiming to be a relative of the Eastwoods, a boy named Logan. He managed to get hold of an original version of Andy's Apple Farm from his great uncle's computer and discovered a new secret. This secret scene shows Thomas in the woodland the night he killed both his family and Arthur. He approaches an axe and is instructed by the entity. "Get out! Get out of my head!" "No, you cannot fight me, Thomas. You have brought this upon yourself."
"No, stop this, please. I don't want to kill him. I don't want to kill anyone."
"I am sorry, Thomas. When did I give you a choice? Kill him." Now with the Eastwood family laid to rest, as well as Arthur to boot, Thomas himself was consumed by the spirit and finally died in March of 1983. We see Thomas transforming into Andy briefly in this shot here. This is the final piece of the puzzle as things stand currently. It seems Thomas found a way to transfer the souls of each of his family members over to people in the game, each of the characters in this sinister story becoming cartoon characters trapped inside the cursed video game. Isabella became Melody. Lewis became Felix. Cameron became Margaret. Arthur became Klaus, and Thomas became Andy, while Peter Pumpkin seems to represent the shadow entity itself. Now these trapped souls cry out for us, the player, to somehow find a way to save them. Currently, we do not know what occurred in the 3 months since the tragic events of Christmas Eve of 1982. It seems likely the entity used Thomas to finish this cursed game and release it for public consumption, but to what end? We'll have to wait and see as the story of Andy's Apple Farm continues in the coming months. But for now, we come to the end of this video looking at the secrets and story of Andy's Apple Farm version 1.4. I hope you found this video both entertaining and informative, and if you did, remember to leave a like, comment down below, and of course subscribe for more horror related content. Thanks for watching, and I will see you.
As the stars start to align, I hope you take it as a sign that you'll be okay. Everything will